This is the problem given in GATE 2014. Here, a 2-bus power system shown in figure supplies load of 1 plus J 0.5 per unit. And this is the power system network given in the problem, where at the first bus the generator is connected and at the second bus the load is connected. The question asked is the values of V1 in per unit and delta 2 respectively are. So for the given power system network, what we need to find is the value of V1, which is magnitude, and delta, which is an angle.
So in the problem given in the question, it is asked to find the voltage V1 for the first bus and delta 2, which is the phase angle for the second bus. So in order to find this voltage and phase angle, just I am finding the power. I am equating this to, we know already the apparent power can be given by S2 is equal to V2 into I2 conjugate. So in order to find V2, see V2 is already given, it is 1 at an angle delta 2, and what we need to find is I2 first. What is I2 actually? I2 can be obtained by subtracting the two voltages and dividing this subtraction with the impedance. So I2 can be given by V1 at an angle 0 degrees minus 1 at an angle delta 2 degrees divided with J 0.1. So if you consider J as angle 90 degrees, V1 by 0.1 will give us 10 V1, 0 degrees, and here it is like 0.1 at an angle 90 degrees. If you send it to numerator, you will get 10 V1 at an angle minus 90 degrees, 0 minus 90. And minus 1 divided by 0.1 again is 10. So the angle is delta 2 minus 90 degrees. So delta 2 minus 90 degrees. This is the actual value of I2. And how can I find I2 conjugate? I2 conjugate can be obtained just by keeping the negative signs for the angle. So I can get now I2 conjugate as 10 V1 at an angle 90 degrees minus 10 at an angle 90 minus delta 2. So this is the I2 conjugate value. By multiplying this I2 conjugate with V2, I will get S2. So now S2 is equal to V2. What is V2? 1 at an angle delta 2. So 1 at an angle delta 2 with I2 conjugate. I2 conjugate is 10 V1 at an angle 90 degrees minus 10 at an angle 90 minus delta 2. This is I2 conjugate and this is V2, so it is S2. Just by multiplying the things, which you will get 10 V1 at an angle delta 2 plus 90 degrees minus 10 into 1. 10 at an angle delta 2 minus delta 2, 0. So you will get 10 at an angle 90 degrees. So this is S2. But S2 is given as this value. This is the real power of the term and this is the imaginary power, imaginary term. So from this, how can we get the real term? So delta 2 plus 90 degrees, delta 2 minus delta 2, 0. So we get 10 at an angle 90 degrees. Okay, no problem. Now, how can I equate this to that? So 1 plus J 0.5 is equal to 10 V1 at an angle delta 2 plus 90 degrees minus 10 at an angle 90 degrees. So, how can I get the real term from this? The real term in this side is 1 and the real term in this side is 10 V1 cos delta 2 plus 90 degrees. Similarly, how can I get the imaginary term? Imaginary term is 0.5 here, and it is equal to, here the imaginary term is 10 V1 sin delta 2 plus 90 degrees minus 10. So at an angle 90 degrees can be written as 10 J. So minus 10 J. So here equating the imaginary terms, you will get these two equations. This is the first equation and this is the second equation. From these two equations, we can get delta 2 value. How can we obtain delta 2 value? So I will show that. Just I want to erase this portion. Now how can I get this? Cos 90 degrees, cos delta 2 plus 90 degrees. It is like cos 90 plus theta. So cos 90 plus theta is in the second quadrant. You will get minus sine delta 2 multiplied with 10 V1 is equal to 1. First equation. Similarly, sin 90 plus delta 2, it is also in the second quadrant, but in the second quadrant we will get positive sign, positive for sine. So you will get cos 9, sin 90 plus delta 2 is cos delta 2 into 10 V1, and it is equal to 0.5. Again you have another term. So it is not the value. If you send this term to here, we get 10.5. So 10.5. Just by dividing the first equation with the second equation, you will get 10 V1, 10 V1 gets cancelled, and you will get tan delta 2 is equal to, and you will get minus, send this term to that side, 1 by 10.5. So from this, if you find delta 2 value, it comes out to be minus 5.44 degrees. If you take delta 2 as, delta 2 is equal to tan inverse of minus 1 by 10.5. So first I have done, after finding delta 2, how can I find V1? See, you know the relation between, you just got the relation between V1 and delta 2. How can we got the relation? See here, from this equation, you can use any equation. So cos delta 2 is equal to, I just substitute this, cos of minus 5.44 degrees is equal to 10.5 by 10 V1. This is the equation. From this equation, you can find this value, and just V1 is equal to 10.5 by 10 into cos this value. So that you will get V1 as equal to 1.05 volts. This is in per unit. So you will get this in per unit. So these are the values of V1 and delta 2 which you can obtain just by using a simple formula, that is I2 is equal to V1 minus V2, means the voltage at bus minus the voltage at bus 2 divided with the impedance, actual impedance that is connected in between the first bus and second bus. From this you can find I2, and equating S2 to V2 into I2 conjugate, you can find the values of unknown things, which is delta 2 and V1. In this way we can solve this problem which was asked in gate examination.
A 183 bus power system has 150 PQ buses and 32 PV buses. In the general case, to obtain the load flow solution using Newton Raphson method in polar coordinates, the minimum number of simultaneous equations to be solved is. So this is the another problem of load flow studies, and it is asked to find the simultaneous equations to be solved. So this is same method which we have used to find the matrix, means Jacobian matrix order.
So this is a very simple problem which was asked on Newton-Raphson method. So here the total number of buses are given as 183. Out of 183 buses, it is given that the number of PQ buses are 150 and the number of PV buses are 32. So the question is asked here is how many equations that we need to solve in Newton-Raphson method polar form. So I told you already whether they ask the number of equations in Newton-Raphson method or whether they ask the order of Jacobian matrix, both are same. So here, out of 183 buses, first bus is, one of the bus is the slack bus. So you will have only 182 buses. To write the Newton-Raphson equations, you will have 182 buses, because one of the bus is considered as slack bus in load flow studies. Out of 182 buses, 150 are PQ buses given in the problem, and 32 buses are PV buses. For PQ buses, we need, for each and every PQ buses, we need two equations. For each PQ bus, we need two equations. What are the two equations? One is for delta P and another one is for delta Q. These are the two equations required for each PQ bus. Similarly, one equation for each PV bus. Because for PV bus, what is the only equation which is required? This is the equation for delta P. Hence, the PQ buses are total in number 150. So, how many equations for PQ bus? 150 into 2. Similarly, how many equations for PV bus? One equation for each PV bus. So, there are 32 PV buses, 32 into 1. So, 150 into 2 is 300 plus 32 into 1 is 32. So, totally we need to have, we need to solve 332 equations when there are 183 buses in the power system network. If for the same problem, if it is asked to find the Jacobian matrix order, the order is 332 by 332. In this way, we can find the Jacobian matrix order as well as the number of equations to be solved for a Newton-Raphson method easily. This is a very simple question with no diversions like reactive power support buses or voltage controlled buses or the buses with shunt capacitors. They will mention in different way, but this is a direct problem where we have specifically PQ and PV buses.
Let us see another question. In a 100 bus power system, there are 10 generators. In a particular iteration of Newton-Raphson load flow technique in polar coordinates, two of the PV buses are converted to PQ type. In this iteration, this is the question. These are the options given for the problem. The number of unknown bus, unknown voltage angle and magnitude. About the voltage angle and magnitude. Whether the angle remains the same or voltage remains the same. Whether the angle increases or voltage increases. Angle decreases or voltage decreases. Like this, they have given four options about the voltage magnitude and its angle.
So this is another problem which was asked on Newton-Raphson method polar form. But in order to understand this problem, one has to solve or one has to do the load flow studies problem on Newton Raphson method. Otherwise, it is somewhat difficult to understand. But I will explain in an easy way. So just they are given that in the power system network, there are 100 buses. Total number of buses are 100. Out of these 100 buses, 10 buses are generator buses, means PV buses. If there are 100 buses, for a load flow solution, what we need to take? We need to consider one bus as the slack bus. So how many buses are there? 99 buses remaining for doing the load flow analysis. Out of these 99 buses, 10 buses are PV buses. So the remaining 89 buses are PQ bus. That we need to understand. Now, it is given that out of 10 generator buses, if 2 of the PV buses are converted to PQ in the particular iteration, then what will happen? In any particular iteration, it may be first, second or third. In any particular iteration, if 2 of the PV buses are converted to PQ, here out of 10 PV, we are converting 2. So the number of PV buses are now 8 PV buses. Now these 2 buses are added to PQ bus. Now how many PQ buses are there? There are 91 PQ buses. When the bus is converted to PQ bus, what is meant by a PQ bus? A PQ bus is a bus where P is specified as well as the reactive power is also specified. Out of 4 parameters at that particular bus, P and Q are specified. And what we need to find is V and delta. So, magnitude of V and delta. Now, if we observe, when the PV buses are converted to PQ bus, in PV bus, when the bus is considered as PV bus, the unknown parameters are Q and delta. When it is converted to PQ bus, the unknown parameters are V and delta. Now, when the PV bus is converted to PQ bus, these will be specified terms and we need to find magnitude of V and magnitude of delta for the converted PQ buses. Means for the converted PQ buses, from PV buses we have converted them to PQ bus. For that converted buses, it may be 3rd, 4th or 10th, 11th, like that. For those converted buses, we need to find V and delta. So previously, those 2 buses have the unknown parameters as Q and delta. Now, the unknown parameters for these 2 buses. For example, it may be Q2 and delta 2, Q3 and delta 3. Second bus and third bus are PV buses. Assume like that. If they are converted to PQ bus, then what are the unknown parameters? Magnitude of V2 and delta 2 and magnitude of V3 and delta 3. Previously, these are the unknown parameters. Now, these are the unknown parameters. In both the cases, what is common? Angle of the voltages at that particular bus. So, when what we can understand from this is, when the PV bus is converted to PQ bus, the number of voltages, the number of unknown voltages, because previously 89 PQ buses are there. So how many unknown voltages? 89 unknown voltages. Now extra 2 are added. For these extra 2, you need to know the voltages again. So totally 91 unknown voltages we need to find. But what about the angle? Angle remains unchanged. Previously, we need to find delta 2, delta 3. Now also, we need to find delta 2, delta 3. So, the correct answer for this question is, when the PV buses are converted to PQ bus, the number of unknown voltages, voltage angles, these are unknown voltage angles, will remain unchanged. But the number of unknown voltage magnitudes will be increased by 2. because previously there are 89 unknown voltages. Now there are 99 unknown voltages. So the correct answer is voltage magnitudes, sorry, voltage angles remains unchanged, whereas the voltage magnitudes must be increased by 2. In this way, we can solve the problem for Newton Raphson method.
This is the another problem, and this is the last problem of this video. A 10 bus power system consists of 4 generator buses indexed as G1, G2, G3, G4 and 6 load buses indexed as L1, L2, L3, L4, L5, L6. The generator bus G1 is considered as slack bus, and the load buses L3 and L4 are voltage controlled buses. The generator at bus G2 cannot supply the required reactive power demand, and hence it is operating at its maximum reactive power limit. The number of nonlinear equations required for solving the load flow problem using Newton-Raphson method in polar form. Here also we need to find the number of nonlinear equations for the Newton-Raphson method. Though this question looks a bit lengthy question, but the solution for this question is simple if you understand how to write the number of equations or how to find the Jacobian matrix in Newton-Raphson method. That we will see now.
In this problem, out of 10 buses of a power system network, there are actually 10 buses of a power system network. Out of the 10 buses, 4 buses are the generator buses and the remaining 6 buses are load buses. We must understand, for a generator bus, the known parameters are the specified parameters as P and magnitude of V. And for a load bus, the specified parameters are P and Q. But directly it is not asked to find the number of equations in a Newton-Raphson method. But they have given a small twist. Here, generator 1 must be considered as a slack bus. Hence, I can neglect the generator 1 in writing the load flow equations. Now there are 3 generator buses only and the remaining 6 are load buses. And we have another condition which is given is L3 and L4 are voltage controlled buses. So in the previous video we have seen a voltage controlled bus will have a FATS device for which the real power is 0 and the magnitude of voltage is known. So the real power and the magnitude of voltage both are known for voltage controlled buses. Hence, L3, L4 also comes under these generator buses. So now I can add for these generator buses, for the existing generator buses, I can add L3 and L4. And I can remove L3 and L4 from the load buses. Similarly, the generator G2 is not supplying, means the generator G2 is not able to supply the reactive power, because the reactive power of the generator must be within the limits. But this generator is, maybe it is generating less than the minimum limit or greater than the maximum limit. So, as the generator G2 has diverging reactive power, its reactive power is fixed, and as the real power is already known, the voltage will be changed for this. Hence, P and Q are the known parameters at the generator G2. So, I can remove the generator G2 from the generator buses and I can add to here. Now, these are the finalized PV buses and the finalized PQ buses for our load flow studies by considering all the conditions. First condition is considering G1 as a slack bus, and the second condition is considering L3, L4 as voltage controlled buses, and the third condition is considering the G2 as PQ bus. By considering all these facts and balancing the number of buses, so what are the number of equations that we need to solve? It depends upon the number of PV buses and the number of PQ buses in the network. So the number of PQ buses are now 4 in number. So how many equations that we can obtain? So for the PV bus, for the PV buses, we will have one equation for each bus. So how many buses are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 into 4, you will have 4 equations that need to be solved for these PV buses. Similarly, how many load buses are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As there are the PQ buses require 2 equations for each bus. As we have 5 load buses, so 2 into 5 is equal to 10 equations. 4 equations from PV buses and 10 equations for PQ buses. Totally, we need to solve 14 equations in the Newton Raphson method polar form when there are 10 buses in the system, considering first bus G1 as slack bus. If the same problem is asked to find the order of Jacobian matrix, the order of Jacobian matrix will be 14 by 14. In this way, we can solve the questions on the Jacobian matrix order or the number of equations to be solved in Newton-Raphson method just by understanding what is the type of bus. If it is a PQ bus, we need to have 2 equations for each PQ bus. And if it is a PV bus, we need to have a single equation for each PV bus. By adding all those equations, we'll get the total number of equations. If you understand how to obtain the total number of equations, you can automatically obtain the order of Jacobian matrix.